Hello Leo, welcome to the Illust Illuminator for your March readings. Just a quick thing that I want to discuss with a lot of you. My concern about the world, alright? And I'm not going to act or be ignorant about it. I did, however, mention a lot in the previous videos, in the first three that I posted. And it's very clear that a lot of people are becoming triggered by it when I tell people to be safe and think clearly and to stay home. I guess one of the reasons is because I'm in Europe and it escalated rather quickly here and it's spreading all over. So I've been already in that process, and for a lot of people it's like still surreal, and perhaps there is like some type of a trigger of like people trying to put like fear into the world, and me talking about how to deal with that is kind of like counterattacking. So I decided that I cannot, you know, I have been a channel of healing and a light worker, so I cannot act like it's not happening and live in an illusional world here. So yeah, the reason that I'm saying it is because of those videos I lost a lot of subscribers, and I'm okay with that. A lot of dislikes because I'm telling people to be safe, and I'm like, okay, so the only reason that you're here is to see if your lover is going to come back. It does not make sense to me, because I am being impacted as well. I am a human being as well, and it's my job to tell people to be safe and to be considering other people and not be like, you know, yeah. I find it very hard to keep myself motivated when I'm doing this type of job, and when you try to help people. Usually when I try to help people, when they were in fear, they were all in lovey-dovey state about it. And now that I help people in the worldwide epidemic or pandemic situation, it's all of a sudden like, oh no, we don't want to hear about that. And that makes me very confused of who I am and what I'm doing, what I'm supposed to do. So I decided to do separate videos about it, and I don't want you guys to know that I am completely ignoring the situation, but I guess that a lot of people are here to get entertainment and to not talk about real life stuff. So yeah, it's hard for me, and I do really count on your support here, or I do count on how you feel as well. So it's really a very conflicting situation for me, because I find it hard to not associate the things that are going on in the world with what is going on in your interpersonal relationships either. So when I mention the things that are in reality going on and you're gonna click off because of that, that's kind of like weird for me. Alright, because if there has been a geographical distance, yeah, that is going to be a big problem in the future for your love situation as well. And you cannot, you know, want me to ignore that situation just because it will make people feel safe about it. Alright, so I'm not going to change my opinion about it. I am still a pro of staying home. That does not mean that I'm trying to cause more fear, but we all need to go through an uncertainty, and we all can have an opinion, sure, you know, we all can say like it's because of this and that and they are trying to do this and that or manipulate blah blah blah. That's all right, that's all fine. We can all have your opinion about why it is happening and who is doing what and whatsoever, but at the end of the day we all are in the same boat, so it does not really matter where is why it's happening or what happened. It's all about like how we survive it, you know. So for me it's a very clear distinguish. So yeah, that's what I wanted to say. So I will do more collective based readings to see, you know, not like a BNN kind of really readings or anything, just how to deal with the energies that are coming towards us, and that is just collective energy that we do need to discuss, and I cannot ignore it. All right, but I do understand that you just want to come here and to hear about your love situation. But You know, for those who have been on the channel, you know that I've always promoted healing and how to deal with anxiety and how to advise you in that. So at this point, if I don't advise you, that's weird. You know, then I'm like, okay, what did I do all this time around? And why did you unsubscribe now and not before when I was telling you how to deal with the anxiety in love? You get what I mean? So I'm just trying to express my feelings about it, that it's making me very confused how to proceed on this journey, because as much as you are here on this journey watching me, I am also a human being that is on a journey with you guys. So I feel like we need to be on the same level. So if you get triggered because I talk about real life stuff that is going on in the world, and out of precaution, I'm telling you to keep safe and stay home, and you get mad about that, okay, then what do you expect me to do? Not care and just sit here? So anyway, that's how I feel about it. So that's why I just want you to know that I am completely aware of it, and I have been aware of it, and I will have some more general readings about the situations or how to deal with situation for those who do really need to know how to ground yourself. Yeah, so let's start the reading for Leo. And by the way, I really do hope that you guys are safe and that you won't get triggered. Oh gosh, it's hard for me. It's really hard for me because when I see some things, it's unusual to not make sense out of the situation, and it's gonna impact you on every level, whether you want to hear it or not. I'm not speaking to you directly, but for those who do want to click off because I'm discussing it, that's why I'm saying it. So you got the King of Wands with the Death card. All right, so some of you are being prepared to handle this situation that you are in, no matter what it is, with a leadership quality, all right? Like, you're taking the lead in trying to take action towards the transformation. This is like an understanding, a higher understanding that you are gaining in order to take action towards the changes that are inevitable. So this is most definitely, the Death card is talking about that big transformation, again, that the world is going through, all right? And this is being, how do I say this? Like, this is being responsible, Leo. Like, I knew that you guys would definitely be one of the people that would most definitely understand what I'm talking about just now in my intro, because we do have that big responsibility within us. We are the fire signs. We want to take action. We want to do something for the world, all right? And I'm not saying that all the other zodiacs don't have that, not at all, but there is this need for, especially for, you know, I don't know, I felt for the Leos, because you are the protector of the zodiac, aren't you? You know what I mean? You are the one that will be, you know, protecting the whole pack, you know, leading the pack, right? So therefore, it's very important for you to keep your head cool, to be careful of the actions that you take or the things that you speak out. But you are definitely on a leadership role here. So some of you are definitely taking a great lead in helping this world transform and to reduce whatever it is that it needs to take. So I do really get that you guys have a very high spiritual impact around this time, is what I'm getting through very, very strongly. Preparation, yeah. This is you guys really being prepared for that big transformation that is going on and understanding the reality. So I'm really glad to see this actually. Yeah, wow, we got the Queen of Swords. So in love situation, you are dealing with someone that is holding back, all right? This person has their own way of thinking. They have their own logic when it comes to dealing with the situation. Whether it's love or outside, there, I see some type of debate going on, all right? And you both may be from different opinions, all right? And you both are looking at this transformation that is going on and wanting to add from your point of view. But the person that you're dealing with, they they're seeing this whole situation very cold and you're seeing it very warm, because I see a warm situation here and a cold situation here. So someone in this situation, and I feel like it's the other person, is being very cold and detached from whatever is going on, whereas you want to take the lead and make a change in the situation here. Could be a air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Oops, that's a lot of cards. Sorry guys, I'm gonna pull them back. You got the Four of Wands, so that is definitely work, home related, all right? I do see that there is some type of a gossip that wants to come through, or that you may have something to say towards your person that you're not really opening up about. I have the Temperance card, so whatever it is that this dispute was in the past, you both are going to reconcile, but I feel that there is a big change in between both of you that is changing both of your world as well as your mind and your behaviors. And I feel like it's hard for both of you to really have a decent talk about the reality of the situation right now. I'm not talking about the world, I'm just talking about the love situation. I feel like there is something that you have on your chest that you have not talked about. You may be trying to check up on them, or they may be trying to check up on you. I do feel, however, that there is going to be a lot of peace that is going to be restored. There is a big reconciliation that is coming up, but I feel like it's more like who is going to have the first talk here. You got the King of Pentacles. The Emperor, there's so much masculine energy here. Like I said, you're really stepping up to your leadership qualities here. You're being very generous, like I said, like you're really a risk taker. Like you are going to do whatever it takes to either, you know, help people or to, you know, raise the vibration when it comes to love. Like you guys have a very high potential of spiritual leadership here. And it's time for you to take advantage of that in the right way and to not be scared of the truths that you want to tell people, because you have the Page of Swords, which is gossip here. So you may be afraid for some reason that there might be a lot of gossiping around you, or that people may not really agree, you know, to your opinion. But this is telling me that you need to keep on being generous, all right? And you need to pour out your wisdom. You have a lot of knowledge and wisdom within you, and it's time for you to really take that leadership role. Again, you got a lot of masculine energy here. Seven of Pentacles and the Ten of Cups. So the dream that you had when it comes to coming together, having that peaceful resolution with your person, it is going to take a little while, all right, maybe a minute or two. There is still a lot of work that needs to be done. You have the Vision card, which is the Seven of Pentacles, and the Ten of Cups, the home card. So there is still a lot of things that you are working on within your home environment, and there is a lot that you still need to invest in order to get to this happy home stage. But you will, as long as you can be disciplined, as long as you have a clear mind, you come from a place of wisdom and knowledge, you will achieve this happy home life, whether you are now together or not, or whether there is this huge mountain in between both of you. If you are living together, it is something that is going to be overbridged, all right? And there is definitely a lot of happiness within the home life. You have Four of Wands and the Ten of Cups, so you know happiness is going to be achieved 100% here. You got the Ace of Wands, so after a lot of challenges, I feel like this situation is going to have a second chance, is going to have a second turnaround. There is a lot of ideas that are going to come to you that can help you and the people around you to, you know, perhaps bring more money onto the table, or be very generous within your time, energy, and effort. So you're gonna help a lot of people is what I'm getting through very, very strongly here. Yeah, honor the masculine. I mean, that's Exactly, you get so many masculine energies, and here is the card saying honor the masculine, respecting men, embracing the masculine divine. So you're definitely in your masculine, powerful role as a real lion to protect your loved ones, to take action without thinking about your pride or ego, and just be there for them, you know. And if you're a masculine, you're doing a great job. If you're a feminine, you're definitely reaching that potential of growing into a more masculine energy that has a lot of courage to take things on. All right, you got vulnerability. Open your heart and allow yourself to be tender. Just because you're masculine does not mean that you cannot express your sensitivity as well. So be careful of that as well. Your person may definitely become also more vulnerable because you are becoming more masculine. So, you know, the roles might be changing is what I'm hearing. But I love this. I knew that I could make this type of intros with you guys. I don't know why. I was like, should I do it? And I was like, it's Leo. They understand you, you know. Look at that, light. Reaching for light. You know, this is the sun. This is again Leo. You know, you are going to be a vessel for bringing light, hope, and growth into the situation. All right, and it's really beautiful to get this card for you out right now. Here again, foundation and achievement. So within the home life, you will definitely experience a lot of happiness, a lot of joy, a lot of action taking. And a lot of healing. This relationship with whomever it is going to be one of peace, one of reconciliation, one with a lot of care, all right? Coming from your end, definitely. Trust, yeah. You guys are definitely going to spread a lot of love and a lot of light, and I feel like that's definitely what is needed right now. So please keep on doing that. You got self-love. I feel like you've already mastered that. That's why you had so many kings and masculine energy. You're already over that. You know, you've already healed yourself to an extent of knowing how to love yourself and spread that love, spread that light, and spread that joy. You're definitely the center at this point of the world is what I'm hearing, you know? Like, people really need people like Leos right now to be that light. So please keep on spreading it. Conclusions are within reach and prosperity lies ahead. Yeah, definitely, because this is the King of Pentacles, which is also definitely Taurusian energy. So you got a lot of prosperity coming up because you guys know how to make or do some work within the home life or create or be inspired to work towards financial goals within the home life. Like, you have that creativity to get that done, and it's going to give you a lot of prosperity in the future. So conclusions are within reach. Like I said, you both need to come to a conclusion about this transformation of the death that is going on. And, you know, like I said in the beginning, agree to disagree. Some people are going to have a different opinion, and, you know, at the end of the day, that's all fine, but it's about actions that we take towards it that is going to make the difference in the first place. Because, to be honest with you, if we look back to history, to all the pandemics or epidemics that has taken place, there is nowhere saying that there was like a robot or someone that just spread it out for fear. No, it just happened. That's history. It's a cycle that the world goes through. So it also, now it does not really make sense to have any type of opinion about who is doing this. You know, that does not going to make any change in the world. That is not going to bring the light in the world. So that's why I'm not going to be a promoter of conspiracy theories. And for those who don't like to hear that because they do have the conspiracy theory, then that's also fine. But I'm not going to promote that, just to keep some followers going, because I know that my tribe is real out there and that we are on the same frequency. And I'm just very, very grateful and thankful for all of you, and for those who want to disturb that. I'm not going to let it affect me. We're just going to go through this together, all right? So, my dear people, I am going to continue with the He Said, She Said spread on Vimeo. So yeah, I just want to say, keep safe. I'm sending you guys a lot of blessings and love all the way from Amsterdam. And yeah, I'll see you next week or beginning of April. Bye.